Let's start with a light, a blinking bulb on a tree, the sun in the sky streaming through the windows, or the flame of a candle, just like this one, on the Advent wreath. The light shines outward in all directions, all the time, making everything it touches brighter. That's how the story of Jesus begins, with the light shining in the darkness.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
Exactly. The light shines in the darkness everywhere in all directions, and the darkness doesn't overcome it. That's Jesus, the light of the world. But there's more to it than that.
And the Word became flesh and lived among us.
Right. Jesus the Word, who was with God in the beginning, who is God with us even right now becoming flesh. He shared our humanity. He came among us, as one of us, with real people in real lives and real history. That's the story we're all here to tell. And it goes like this. A long time ago, about 2,000 years ago, in fact, God sent an angel with a message to a young woman named Mary. Mary was just minding her own business and folding laundry when the room was filled with dazzling light in all directions. That came from the heavenly visitor. Mary was stunned. This was not what she was expecting on laundry day. And the bright light of the angel's appearance frightened her. Yep, just like that. Well, the angel could tell that Mary was scared and probably confused, so the angel said to Mary, "Don't be afraid, I have good news for you." Yep, just like that. Mary decided to trust the angel and was ready to listen. So the angel told her that God wanted her to be the mother of the long-awaited Savior, the Messiah, who would bring God's love in all directions to all people everywhere. At first, Mary didn't understand. She wasn't planning on having a baby. She wasn't ready for that. And what would her fiancé Joseph think about all of this? She had so many questions. The angel told her again, "Don't be afraid. I'm asking you to trust that God has got everything figured out, and that the baby you'll have will come from the Holy Spirit, because he will be none other than your God's own son. Will you trust that God can make this happen? Will you let God work for you?" Mary thought for a moment about how God had been faithful and reliable before, and how God had done amazing things for her people so many times in the past. She dared to believe that God would do this amazing thing now, and she was willing to be part of God's plans to show love in all directions through her baby. She said yes.
"Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me, just as you have said."
"Yeah, that's what I said," she said. Anyway, after Mary had said yes to being the mother of God's promised Savior, that still left the matter of explaining everything to Mary's fiancé, Joseph. You see, Mary and Joseph were planning on to be married soon. But once Joseph found out that Mary was going to have a baby, he wasn't sure what to think. He thought maybe Mary didn't want to be married to him, or maybe it would be better if they just broke up. And just when he had decided it might be best to call off the wedding, an angel showed up to Joseph. And once again, the bright light shining in all directions from the angel's face scared the willies out of Joseph, who was also just minding his own business. Well, the angel said the very same thing to Joseph that had worked with Mary. The angel said, "Don't be afraid." Yep, just like that. The angel continued to tell Joseph that Mary's baby was actually from God, that her son would be the long-awaited Savior who would share God's love in all directions for all people. The angel said Joseph didn't need to be afraid still to get married. He would be needed to raise the baby too. It was a lot to take in, but Joseph decided to trust the message from the angel too. He was willing to be part of God's plan, even though he wasn't sure how it would all work out. In another flash of light, the angel was gone, and Joseph went to find Mary and tell her what the angel had said. Well, it wasn't much longer that the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus declared he wanted to count all the people in his empire, and for everyone to go back to their family's hometown to be registered. That meant that Mary and Joseph would have to leave Nazareth, where they were living, and go to the city of Bethlehem, about 100 miles away. They walked or rode a donkey all that way, and when they finally arrived in Bethlehem, it was just about time for Mary to deliver her baby. But after all that traveling and searching in all directions, there was pocket private room. The best anybody could offer was the place where the animals fed at night. So Mary and Joseph used what they could, and Mary had her baby, a son. They wrapped him in tight bands of cloth, and they laid him in a borrowed manger, the food trough that the animals ate out of. Mary was very tired and ready for this adventure to be over. Meanwhile, outside of town, some shepherd was minding his own business out in the fields around Bethlehem. He was keeping an eye on his flock and making sure the sheep didn't run off in all directions. He was hoping things would settle down for the night and that he could get some sleep soon. But you know how things go. God has a way of showing up and shaking things up when you least expect it. God sent an angel to the shepherd, appearing in the sky over the Bethlehem pastures in a flash of light that shone in all directions. And you guessed it, the dazzling sight scared the willies out of the shepherd. So the angel, who was getting very good at this, said to the shepherds, "Don't be afraid. I'm bringing you good news of great joy for everyone everywhere. To you this day is born in the city of David in Bethlehem a Savior, who is the promised Messiah you've been waiting for. This is how you'll recognize him. Look for a baby wrapped in bands of cloth, lying in a manger." The next thing they knew, the sky was suddenly full of angels, stretching out in all directions, and they were all praising God, saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all whom God favored."
When the angels finished the musical number, the shepherds decided to go to Bethlehem and see what the angels had to show them about. He went as quickly as he could into town, and he found Mary and Joseph and the child in the manger, just as the angels had said. He told them about the angel's message, and everybody was amazed. Mary held on all these words and treasured them in her heart, and she knew something amazing was just getting started. The kids are going to pass out ornaments, and each family will get one ornament. The shepherds went out praising God and telling the news in all directions about what they had seen and heard, so that everyone would learn about how God had come among them and sent the Savior they had been waiting for. And from there, the news spread, neighbors to neighbors, friends to friends. Eventually, the movement of Jesus' followers spread in all directions to reach the whole world with the news of God's love, even to you and me. And now we're part of it. We're part of the story as well. As God sends us into the world with the same good news given to Mary and Joseph, to shepherds and to all the people in Bethlehem.
Don't be afraid. God has sent the Savior we've been waiting for. And God's love is spreading out in all directions so that the world will know. God has sent us Jesus.
Yeah, that. God has come to us in Jesus with love reaching in all directions like a light shining in the darkness, a light that the darkness will never come. Now, like one candle is lit from another and the lights multiply to fill the room, we are sent to the world with the news of God's love and the promised Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus, and we are sent to in all directions.